6.
Yeah, right there.
Did you know that the All-Star games are announced? Like, delete, because I know that's fake.
All you have to do is give us your credit card information and we'll tell you what the rosters are. What was that dude just screaming in the stands? Do you hear that? Am I losing my mind?
I heard something. Well, we finally, alright, back to reality. We got OBX versus Death Valley. OBX wanted to see Ace Faulkner pitching. We actually watched Swifties versus Sentinels a few games ago, yeah. Which reminds me, I should be showing the box scores at least of those games.
Are you not sure there'll be another minor league game, or not sure there'll be another perfect game?
Yeah. I gotta look through the schedule again, see how far we're going and how it all lines up. See if we're gonna get another minor league game in today.
The only one of those that I care about, the minors. Go Swift Steeds, am I right? Matt Carbine looking good and 4 outs thus far. Oh,
man.
He already walked a guy, so we can say the word perfect game again.
Well, how many perfect games have been pitched on May 18th, 2022?
Well, in real life.
By a Death Valley pitcher.
Hawaii hit the only RBI of the game. It was a 1-0 game. And Hawaii hit a double to the corner on the left. Scored a run. And that was the only run of the game. Death Valley now with 3 hits in 2 1/3 innings. After seeing a game that we had just seen, that hit count just seems unreal.
Very, very surprising. Biggio's been on base. He's been on first for the past 2 batters. Wild steal.
Maybe after leading the league in caught steals this time, him and like Ziggy Kofei probably had a bet. Because we all know either one of them can lead the league in steals.
Yeah.
But who cannot lead the league in caught stealing along the way? So I like to imagine the two of them maybe have a little side bet going on.
Yeah, that's a much more realistic competition. Who gets caught less? What's the difference between stealing 70 and 75? You know?
Yeah, at the end of the day, you just stole second or third base, probably home a few times too, more times than anybody could dream of stealing a base in a lot more games. So, yeah, if I were banking on my TPE for the postseason, which I wouldn't, but theoretically, if that's how I treated my TPE, I would just wait till the very end, and if I saw I was playing Death Valley, I'd just put it all on hold runners. Like, go ahead, get
a long con.
But you can't steal.
The very long con.
You're allowed to get a single, but you're not allowed to steal second. And then after everybody gets a single and the bases are loaded, and Dew hits a grand slam, then I realized the strategy was bad.
Yeah, but your strategy did what it set out to do, so...
No one...
Is it bad? Yeah, exactly.
And Connor Tanner gets one to right field, but it's caught. Paulo De Stefano back in his Scorpions uniform. There were some talks. I don't know if it was just us in the booth or if there was any actual consideration, but I was hoping next time we saw the Scorpions, they would unveil a nice, more flashy red uniform.
Yeah.
I think it was probably just us talking in the booth, and then I just wanted to see it happen.
Wasn't me, but I do remember you guys talking about it in the booth.
Biggio steals third and gets home.
See, the scariest part of Biggio and Coffey is not the fact that they can steal so much, it's the fact that they can get on base at like an almost 400 clip also.
Yep.
Even if they don't steal.
Yeah, and then ground out there, runner advances to third.
Mm-hmm.
So, even though Ziggy would be on scoring position from first on a base hit like that, I mean, you can get a slow roller on the infield and you can score from third too.
Mm-hmm.
A lot easier than he could first, but I wouldn't put it past him. So Dew's got a double, RBI.
DeStefano's still looking for his first hit of the season.
He must have left his bat in Providence.
If Philly has their nice black uniform, yeah, it's always nice to go out in the 120 degree weather.
Wear black.
Nice black jersey.
All right, we can say the words "no hitter" again, as that's broken up in the top of the fifth, or bottom of the fifth, first batter.
Bobby Shmurda. Cantone sabotage the wrong bets.
Maybe we should investigate some bats, see how many have cork or pine tar up just barely too far. The benches clearing brawl going. And that will not
nice catch.
Biggio covers a good amount of distance there.
The Diamondbacks do have black jerseys and they play in Arizona. Is Death Valley in a dome? They gotta be, right? Not that it really matters.
Doesn't look like a dome to me.
This is Outer Banks, but...
Oh, yeah. Good point. I couldn't hear my fish tank, so I couldn't tell we were on that. Where is that?
You couldn't hear the kids playing on the beach?
No. And that'll be a sack fly for Biggio. Jameson
yeah.
Checked in. Called out, got him at second. It's a glass dome and they call it the greenhouse.
Literally dying.
And they wear all black. They win their game because opponents feel sympathy for how courageous the players are willing to literally die.
I remember Troutner was saying at some point in the PBE chat, Death Valley best fans in baseball, for that exact reason. They'll sit out there in the 120 degree weather and watch their team play.
Yep. I just hope that the Death Valley organization isn't taking advantage of the situation they have at hand and don't charge like $13 for a water bottle.
Most exorbitant prices. They aren't. Where's Death Valley? Yeah. California?
Yeah, California. I mean, they probably end up having to pay $13 a bottle after Californian sales tax.
Yeah, exactly. $20 for any kind of drink there.
Yep.
First hit, DeStefano?
Nope.
Not yet.
0 for 15. At this pace, Paulo DeStefano is on pace to go 0 for whatever.
We'll say 0 for 300, 400.
And a good double play there. Second to short to first. And Benson's called out on strikes.
Great start for Carbine so far. 7 innings. 87 pitches.
Carbine definitely earned the long leash after going 5 innings of hitless baseball and has allowed just 1 run in 7 innings. Mm-hmm. 4 hits. And with a 4-run lead, I wouldn't, you know, use Musgrave Smythe unless I need to. Give the man a day off when he can get one. And Kecton goes down swinging. That brings up Biggio with 2 outs now. Wild pitch.
Oh yeah, I was gonna say. Yep. Like, that's gonna be a tough throw, but he's fast. Not that that matters, apparently.
And he steals second. He's out.
Risky.
Yeah, Carbine's only thrown 90 pitches now. 92. And that should be a double play, it is.
Smoked.
Hard hit ball by Jake Stennett, but good fielding there on the hot corner. Do over there now. We go to the ninth. Scorpions with a chance to add some additional insurance runs. Two outs is Do steps in the batter's box.
And not much of a fight going on for any of these games today. 6-1, 4-0, 7-1, I think, are the scores.
Yep, 7-1, 4-0, 6-1. And I imagine they'll pull Mac now as he's exceeded 100 pitches and gave up a base hit there. Nope. They keep him in, and Connor McDonald homers off.
Good first dong of the year.
Of McCormick and McDonald being able to get on base and homer. Save situation now for Guy Walker.
That's all it was.
Connor Tanner flies out to short.
It was a ploy to get the save situation for Guy Walker.
Gotta pad some stats. Managers have Guy Walker in fantasy baseball. Guy Walker
able to
get 3 consecutive outs. He gets the save. Scorpions hold off. Aviators fight in the bottom of the ninth. Come up 3 runs short.
Kevin Biggio, player of the game. Swipe 2, call once. Went 3 for 4. 2 RBI, 2 runs. Lots of multi-hit games for them today. Bobby Schmurder, Connor McDonald at the home run. John Doe, Jun Do. Fujiwara Martin. Lots of hits today. Yeah, two errors for Kenny McCormick. Yeah, now you know how it feels to make that shift from second to short. It hurts.